Hi, I'm Marco from REDcatch. I'm one of the developers of the REDtoolbox, and in this short video, we'll look at the updated post-processing and geotagging workflow in the 3.1 version of the REDtoolbox. Once you open the tool, you'll find three areas. To the left, you have a tab navigation bar, to the middle, you find a work area, and to the right, you have a status and results area. The tab navigation allows you to navigate between different aspects of a given project by swapping out your workspace area, which allows you to switch between different aspects without interrupting your workflow. The most important tab is the project setup tab, where you can define the project. First, you select the device which is used to capture the project from the device list. Once you've selected the device, you set the correction type to be applied. The availability of certain correction types depends on the device selected. Once you've selected the correct correction type, you may then select the output height to be used, which may either be elliptical or geoid. For more information on geoid handling, please visit our video on geoid handling in the 3.1 version. Once you have finished those steps, you can use our new auto search feature. It allows to automatically search and load all relevant files given your project setup. To use, simply press the automatically search project files button shown in the project setup tab. Select there the topmost folder of your project. In cases where the project consists of multiple flights or sessions, or in cases where the software is not certain of the purpose of a file, REDtoolbox will not automatically load the file, but instead offer you the option to select from the found files and select the correct file or files to be loaded. As we can see to the right in the status area, a new box has appeared. The box informs you of any issues which prevent the project from being processed. You may cycle through the issues using the exclamation mark button to the right. If you wish to solve the open issues, then look to the navigation tab and search for the graphical indication of any issues. As you can see, there are no issues related to images. Next, we can see in the robot tab that no trigger raw files are loaded as indicated by the issue counter. If we click the drop-down relevant file mask, then we can see that REDtoolbox found both files and presents us with a choice which one to use. In this case, we select both files and then press load. REDtoolbox will now load and merge the files selected. Note that this merge operation works for all supported file types and devices. Should it happen that for some reason the file you want to use was not found, then you may use the select button to manually select the file from wherever you wish. We follow the same procedure for the raw file, and if we click into the drop-down relevant file mask, then we can see that in this case there are quite a few files. You can always search the file list by simply writing into the selection mask. In this case, we select both bin files, and then press load. REDtoolbox will convert, merge, and load these files automatically. As we can see, there are no more issues for our project. However, for completeness sake, we also visit the base tab in order to verify the files loaded for the base station. If it looks good, then we move on to the output tab. Here, we define the outputs to be produced. For a more detailed description of the output formats, you may always hover over them for a tooltip description. We can also define a constant shift to be applied to the triggers generated. Lastly, we define the output folder destination. In this case, we selected the root of the project folder. Once all of that is done, we can now run and generate the output. While the project processes, it reports the number of fix, float, and other solutions generated in the bar chart in the status area. Processing may take a while, depending on the size of the project. In order to save you some time, we sped up the footage of the actual processing. Once the processing is finished, REDtoolbox will, in addition to reporting the number of solutions generated, also tell you how many images and triggers were successfully matched. We can now also access the map tab in which the positions of the triggers are graphically depicted. Note that these icons are color-coded depending on the solution type associated with this trigger. You may also switch them off and simply display the path of the robot taken, or simply display both at the same time. Next is a tab containing detailed table of each trigger. In most cases, this will not be terribly interesting. Finally, we can look at the output by using the Open Output Directory button above. Here, we can see the output generated by the REDtoolbox for this project. In most cases, this will be the end and you can close the tool. However, should you have, for instance, forgotten some output, then you can use the Generate Output button for this. In this case, we add back in the PDF report to be generated. In particular, we can change all the output formats and also enter shift numbers to be applied. Then we press Generate Output, and this will produce a subfolder in the original output folder containing the outputs produced using the process project as a starting point. Pressing the Open Output Directory button now shows a subfolder containing the additional outputs produced with regards to the shift entered. This concludes our short demonstration of the new and updated workflow for post-processing and geotagging. A 14-day free trial of the software can be downloaded from our website displayed on the screen. For more information about the REDtoolbox and REDcatch, please visit our website. Thank you and see you soon.